Hi, I am going to demonstrate creating a simple model in Numinal. First, I take some shapes from the shelf and place them on the stage. Then, I scale the cylinder. I do this by pressing the scale button to enter scale mode, and then touch the cylinder with two fingers and spread them apart. Then, I change the colors. To do this, I enter coloring mode by pressing the color picker, and then touching shapes to give them the selected color. This is repeated for each color. I subtract the spheres from the cylinder to create eyes. Tap a shape twice to change the combining operation of a shape, which are addition, subtraction, and intersection, not shown in this video. To make the combination of shapes into one shape, I move them to the stack at the bottom of the screen, and then drag the combined shape back to the stage. To make a mouth, I subtract a bottom edge of a pyramid using the same method as before. I move the shape toward and away from the screen using two fingers when not in scaling mode. Then I color the mouth as before. I put the shapes together using the stack. I've accidentally changed the color, so I will undo it. I use cylinders for the centers of the eyes. I pull the model closer by spreading my fingers and push the cylinders in by pinching them together. Solid mode is useful for moving connected shapes together without grouping. I tap the shape twice with two fingers to rotate the shape around its center. I group the shapes using the stack again. I'm going to use a cylinder for some teeth. After coloring it white, I use a tap and drag in scaling mode to flatten it. As I line up the white cylinder, notice the orthogonal view called the Z camera. It can help with depth perception. I use solid mode to preview and then put it back in the stack. I'm going to create some eyebrows using a cylinder and a sphere. I stretch the cylinder first to make sure it cuts all the way through the sphere, and then rotate and subtract it. Notice the subtracted shape turns into a blue wireframe, which can be moved as any other shape. Then I color both the sphere and cylinder underneath black. Instead of the stack, I use the shelf to store the eyebrow so that I can make copies. I flatten them a bit. And then drag the face model back from the stack, and then move the eyebrows into place. I name the stage by tapping the name. Random names are assigned to each new stage, but they can be changed. I use the share button to export the current stage. FCT is the native format, which preserves all shape data. I can also export USDZ to use with other apps, such as Procreate. The exported shapes are texture mapped to allow texture painting. GLB is also supported. Thank you.